Good morning, students. Today I am going to discuss about first law of thermodynamics for non-flow process. First law of thermodynamics for non-flow process. Non-flow process means it is a closed system. Non-flow process means it is a closed system. Closed system. In closed system, there is no exchange of mass between system and surrounding. No exchange of mass between system and surrounding. Only exchange of energy between system and surrounding. Exchange of energy between system and surrounding. Exchange of energy between system and surrounding. System and surrounding is nothing but it is inverse. System and surrounding is nothing but it is inverse. See, the first law of thermodynamics, that means law of conservation of energy. Law of conservation of energy states that the total energy in the universe is constant. The total energy in the universe is constant. That means changes in total energy of the system is exactly counterbalanced by changes in total energy of the surrounding. Changes in total energy of the system is exactly counterbalanced by changes in total energy of surrounding. Clear? Whatever the changes in energy of the system is equal to changes in energy of the surrounding, but in the opposite direction. Clear? For non-flow process, this is a closed system. In closed system, there is no exchange of mass. This is also called as controlled mass. There is no exchange of mass between system and surrounding. Only exchange of energy between system and surrounding. System and surrounding is nothing but it is inverse. First law of thermodynamics, law of conservation of energy, states that the total energy in the universe is constant. Total energy in the universe is constant. Consequently, the changes in total energy of the system is exactly counterbalanced by total changes in total energy of the surrounding. That means whatever the changes in energy of the system is equal to changes in the energy of surrounding, but in the opposite direction. Let us see one by one. What about the changes in system? Energy in, what about the changes in energy of the system? What about the energy, changes in energy of the surrounding? First, changes in total energy of the surrounding. See, changes in energy, changes in total energy of the surrounding occurs only through exchange of heat and work. Only through exchange of heat and work with the system. Okay, let us explain. Consider a piston cylinder arrangement. This is cylinder, this is piston. Assume that it contains certain amount of fluid. A known quantity of fluid. This is piston cylinder arrangement or system. Outside of the system is surrounding. If supposed to supply certain amount of heat from surrounding to system, certain amount of heat is transferred from surrounding to system. Based on the surrounding, the heat supplied from surrounding to the system is the negative quantity. Heat is a negative quantity. Okay. Similarly, certain amount of work done by the surrounding on the system. Certain amount of work done by the surrounding on the system. Based on the surrounding, work done by the surrounding is called as positive quantity. Work is a positive quantity. Hence, changes in total energy of the surrounding means changes in total energy of surrounding is equal to minus Q plus W. Minus Q plus W. Next. Changes in energy of system. Changes in total energy of system. There are three factors causes to change total energy in the system. First point, changes in potential energy. Second point, changes in kinetic energy. Third point, changes in internal energy of the system. There are three factors to change the energy, total energy of the system. Hence, changes in total energy of the system is equal to changes in potential energy plus changes in kinetic energy plus changes in internal energy. Changes in internal energy. Okay, now I am going to equate these two terms, changes in total energy of the system and changes in total energy of the surrounding. Changes in potential energy plus changes in kinetic energy plus changes in internal energy is equal to minus of minus Q plus W. Right? This is changes in total energy of the system is exactly counterbalanced by changes in total energy of the surrounding. For steady state non-flow process, for any steady state non-flow process, there is no role for potential energy and there is no role for kinetic energy. Hence, this equation becomes del U is equal to Q minus W. This is the mathematical representation of first law of thermodynamics for non-flow process. It states that the changes in internal energy of a system under closed condition is equal to amount of heat added to the system minus work done, amount of work done on the system. Changes in internal energy of a system under closed condition or non-flow process is equal to amount of heat added to the system minus amount of work done on the system. Clear? In differential form, du is equal to dq minus dw. Du is equal to dq minus dw. Coming to the point of dw, work done on the system. Work done on the system. Usually, work is equal to force into displacement. Force is nothing but pressure into area. And displacement is nothing but changes in volume dv per unit cross section area. Hence, A gets cancelled. dw is equal to p into dv. Okay, ma? Work done on the system. Listen this example. See this example. This is the system. This is a piston cylinder arrangement. Cylinder, piston. Piston cylinder arrangement. It contains an amount of fluid within it. Outside of the system is called as surrounding. Some amount of heat is transferred from surrounding to system. Upon the addition of heat, the temperature of fluid starts to increase. Increase in temperature causes increase in internal energy. Due to increase in internal energy, by default, the fluid starts to expand. The fluid starts to expand. See, to oppose this expansion, certain amount of work done by the surrounding on the system. Heat is supplied to the system. Due to supplied heat, there is a rise in temperature. Consequently, internal energy increases. Due to increase in internal energy, the system or fluid tends to expand. To counterbalance or oppose the expansion process, certain amount of work done by the surrounding on the system. So there is no changes in volume. There is no changes in volume. Volume is constant. Volume is constant. Clear? Volume is constant. Only increase in pressure and temperature. Only increase in pressure. Since volume is constant, P PdV term becomes 0, W term becomes 0. Hence this equation becomes du is equal to dq, or you can write like this, del u is equal to q. Constant volume process. That means a process under constant volume condition. A process under constant volume condition. Amount of heat added to the system. Amount of heat added to the system from surrounding is equal to changes in internal energy of the system. Amount of heat added to the system from surrounding. Amount of heat added to the system is equal to changes in internal energy of the system. Once again, I repeat. This is first law of thermodynamics for non-flow process. Non-flow process means it is a closed system. In closed system, there is no exchange of mass between system and surrounding. Hence, this process is called as controlled mass. Only exchange of energy between system and surrounding. System and surrounding is nothing but it is universe. According to first law of thermodynamics, law of conservation of energy, the total energy in the universe is constant. Hence, changes in system is exactly counterbalanced by changes in surrounding. Changes in total energy of the system is exactly counterbalanced by changes in total energy of the surrounding. Changes in total energy of the system is nothing but due to potential energy, kinetic energy and internal energy. For steady state non-flow process, there is no role for potential energy and kinetic energy. Hence, changes in total energy of the system is equal to changes in internal energy of the system. Coming to this side, changes in total energy of the surrounding. Changes in energy occurs only through exchange of heat and work with the system. Based on surrounding, amount of heat transferred from surrounding to system is negative quantity, minus Q. Amount of work done by the surrounding on the system is a positive quantity. Hence, changes in total energy of the surrounding is equal to minus Q plus W. Equating these two, changes in potential energy plus changes in internal kinetic energy plus changes in internal energy is equal to minus half minus Q plus W. There is no role for potential energy and kinetic energy. Hence, this equation becomes del U is equal to Q minus W. This is the mathematical representation of first law of thermodynamics for non-flow process. It states that the changes in internal energy of the system under closed condition is equal to amount of heat transferred to the system minus work done on the system by the surrounding. In differential form, du is equal to dq minus dw. This is nothing but amount of work done on the system. By default, W is equal to work is equal to force into displacement. Force is nothing but pressure into area. Displacement is nothing but changes in volume per unit cross section area. Hence, dW is equal to P into dV. Work done. See, amount of heat transferred from surrounding to system causes to expansion. To avoid expansion, equal amount of work done on the system. Hence, volume is constant. For constant volume condition, dW is equal to 0. Hence, this equation becomes du is equal to dq, or you can write like this, del u is equal to q under constant volume condition. This states that for a process under constant volume condition, amount of heat added to the system is equal to changes in internal energy. This is the first law of thermodynamics for non-flow process. Thank you.